my heart. It seems so easy now. Everything I dreamed about when I was a child. It looks like a good place here, so I think I'll stay for a while. And if I fall, I will find a way back to my hands. I'm the only one who can help me find my feet again. Well, you came here screaming and never stopped to listen to your one and only prayer. A place for you somewhere. And if I fall, I will find a way back to my hands. Though I'm the only one who can help me find my feet again.
I was born on Prince Edward Island in 1973 and lived with some fairly artistic parents, I guess you could say, fairly artistic. Ever since I was young, I loved to sing, and my mom said that I hummed and sang music before I even spoke. I wrote my first song when I was 12 and started playing guitar when I was about 12. When I was 13, I knew that I had a father who lived in British Columbia. And I'd grown up with a wonderful father who taught me how to play guitar and write songs and sing harmony, but he wasn't my biological father. So when I was about 13, we had a fire in our house that pretty much took everything except for our lives, and I realized what was important at that time, and I came to British Columbia to find my dad, and he's turned out to be a wonderful man. He is also a singer. A very wonderful natural singer, so it was a really great move, and I fell in love with this coast, and yeah, I plan to make my life here.
Of leaving you settling. Oh. Am I fair? Am I strong? When I'm there, do I belong? Is it only skin and touch when I reach for you? Wave goodbye, settling.
One of my favorite places in BC is Salt Spring Island. I got married there and I lived there for quite a while and wrote a lot of my songs from my first record there. I was on the ferry and decided to bring out the guitar, and I was with some friends who were also musical, so we were just sort of jamming actually, and I sang a couple of songs. One of them was Let Her Feel the Rain, which is one of the first songs that I have written, and it just seemed really, really perfect that people were standing around and the sun was shining and everything felt great. A couple of women specifically were leaning over the railing looking out at the water, and I noticed them, kept on singing. No one seemed to mind, everyone seemed to be happy. So as we were pulling into Fulford Harbor, they approached me on the top deck still and said, "That was really nice. Was that last one your own song? I didn't recognize that song." And I said, "Yeah." They ended up giving me a record deal. Isn't that hilarious?
Just
One of the funnest tours that I have done was Lilith Fair. I got to see the Pretenders, Stevie Nicks and Sheryl Crow together. It was just so fantastic. And I got to sing with the Indigo Girls and Sarah McLachlan. And it was a pretty incredible experience overall. Playing in front of 40,000 people, I can't describe the feeling, especially when they're clapping for you and the lights are on you. It's just such an incredible feeling. And you feel them as a mass, you know, and to have them all silent while you're singing, it's an incredible feeling. And to play for a small group of people is almost harder because you can see right into their eyes. You know, you're really raw, you're really bare there. I mean, you can hide behind, you know, great lights and a big stage, but when you're just standing there with your guitar, it's like, oh, okay, here it goes.
Try to swallow you. Thank you.
One of the things that has been happening lately, we're working really, really hard. We're doing, you know, sometimes 3 performances a day, 3-4 sometimes, but I've tried to stop that. It's a little much. But one thing we do is a lot of breakfast television.
Welcome back to Fox Thing in the Morning, Chicago 7.
Broadcasting live for Dallas and Fort Worth. This is Good Day.
This is 11 Alive's Peachtree Morning.
She's built quite a fan base here in the U.S. thanks to Lilith Fair. Now Canadian-born Tara McLean is making an even bigger splash with her newest CD.
We've been known to drive through the night from one city to the next without sleep and show up at 6 a.m. to do breakfast television. And, or, you know, usually no more than 3 hours sleep when we're doing that. So it's really quite hilarious. We're all completely exhausted and punchy, and it can get pretty silly in the morning.
I know you've been on the road all night long.
Yeah.
How do you do that? I mean, 3:30 in the morning, leaving Nashville, getting mm-hmm. here, and then boom, out it comes.
I have no idea how I do it. So I'm from Prince Edward Island, from Charlottetown, and I grew up speaking French when I was little, and I'm not so good at it anymore, but I really wanted to incorporate this beautiful language into my record. And my good friend, Lenny Gallant, who's also a Maritimer, wrote this next song. It's called La Tempête.
Solitaire à la fenêtre, un visage regarde la mer. Elle cherche pour y voir une signe pour lui donner l'espoir. Par miracle, il est sauvé et toutes ses prières sont exaucées. La nouvelle s'est répandue, les voisins viennent à la maison. Pendant chapelet sauf pour le vent, n'y a que le son. Les enfants qui se demandent, qui ne peuvent pas comprendre, pleurent comme maman dit, papa viendra bientôt, il viendra bientôt. Thank you.
Thank you. Veda Hilly.
I met Bill when I was touring with Tom Cochran, and I was opening solo, just me and my guitar, and Bill was his guitar player. And I met him and fell in love with him immediately. And we started making some music together right away, so to speak. It's very natural for us to work together musically. He co-wrote quite a few songs on the new record and co-produced it as well. And we work together so well. Changing, always still breathing. Blake Manning is our percussionist, and he and Bill have played together off and on for the last 10 years, so they've known each other for a long time. And Blake is a great guy, and so bringing him in was very natural. Because he was a friend, and I had never played with a drummer, and I was nervous, and he made me feel very, very comfortable. And he's also married and has a little girl, so yeah, real strong concept of family, really wonderful, responsible, and brilliant musician. About growing up near water, being from the Maritimes. I know a lot about the healing power of water, and then coming to Vancouver, it's very special for me to be here and play my music. This is a song about that. It's called Jordan.
Oh,
think that songs come to me when I'm in need of some kind of hope, and they're my tool for finding it. And oftentimes the songs have come more when I've been swimming through some darkness. We need to go to those places in order to find courage. And when I would go there, it's a very frightening place sometimes, and my songs would help me dig my way out. Who would tap dance down the stairs when my parents had company and say, ta-da, here I am, and try to make little skits up with my sister, and we'd always put on plays for the family. So I'm very extroverted. I've always had a need, I guess, for some kind of attention. There is no right path, and I know that now. You know, I thought from as a child that I would do something very straight. I was going to be a lawyer, and I was going to do something stable. And I realized that there is no such thing. That life is going to hand you a whole lot of curveballs, and I love it now. I'm ready. I'm ready to catch it, and I'm ready to fall on my face. There are so many horror stories about the music business, and I honestly, the team that's around me is so incredible and so nurturing. And all they want me to do is be myself. And so I get to just do that every day. I get to be myself. I get paid to be myself. It's pretty cool. And so, I'm thankful for a lot of things, but mostly I'm thankful for the songs because they get me by.
Thank you. I'd like to introduce Bill Bell on the guitar over here. And Blake Manning on percussion, drums. Thank you. And I'm Tara McLean, but you know that. This next song is called Divided, and it's a song about not judging each other for what we believe.
Soon.
Thank you so much.